joke. I'd like to buy the world a token, teach the world to sing in perfect harmony, and teach the world to snuff the fires and the liars. Hey, I know it's just a song, but it's fine for the recipe. This is a love attack. I know it, our body's back. It's just like any fat. It retracts before impact. And just like fashion, it's a passion for the withered and hip. If you got the goods, they'll come and buy it just to stay in the click. So don't delay, act now. Supplies are running out. Allow it your skin.
What's going down, Niner Empire? It's your boy Danny G in the house. The Niners are 4-0, and we got the Rams in LA. It is the biggest game of the year so far. Finally, that divisional game that we need to prove that we are the best team in this division. It is between us and the Seattle Seahawks for this division, not this LA loser Rams team. All right? Now let's. Bottom line, yes, I know this Rams team was in the Super Bowl. I also know this Rams team only scored 3 points in the Super Bowl. 3 points. That's it. In the Super Bowl. Unbelievable. Hey, and who are the only undefeated teams right now? The Niners and the Patriots. I'm not saying this is going to happen. I am not at all. It could, of course. That would be awesome if it did. But just hear me out. Niners, Patriots, if there was a Super Bowl between them, do you think the 49ers would only score 3 points in it? The answer is no. The Niners have way more offensive weapons to be able to get more points on the board than three. You guys lost two drives when you just needed a touchdown to get back into the game because it was only 10-3. Jared Goff could not get it done. He couldn't. Now, is he a bad quarterback? No, he's a decent quarterback. Does he kind of choke under pressure? Yeah, unfortunately he does. And, you know, this year, you guys lost 55-40 to a Buccaneers team that we beat week one. Well, a team that a lot of you Rams fans admitted was not a good team. But hey, you know, it's all good. You guys are 3-2, we're 4-0. This is our chance to prove that we are the best team in this division. This is our chance to almost guarantee a playoff spot by beating the first division opponent that we face. Now, is it going to be a close game? I'll say it probably will be. But Jared Goff, man, at times, he just... Even the passes that he completes, just they just look ugly sometimes. I mean, they just look, ugh. And your main offensive weapon that you have, Todd Gurley, is not playing. So we're going to be able to run all over you, and it's not going to be so easy for you to run all over us. Bottom line. Now, yes, we do have some injuries that might affect our running game with Mike McGlinchey and Kyle Juszczyk being injured. Kyle Juszczyk isn't going to be able to block, of course. And we're also not going to be able to use him as an offensive weapon like we've done this year. Mainly in the Steeler game is what I'm referring to with that. So, not having Kyle Juszczyk on the line and as an offensive weapon, that's going to be a little bit of a blow. Not having Mike McGlinchey also is going to affect the running game. Might also affect Jimmy's protection a little bit as well, but I think it could gonna completely destroy our running game and destroy our protection of Jimmy and G. No, absolutely not. We've been running down teams' throats all year long so far. Matt Breida was a beast, and of course Tevin Coleman played against the Browns, and he had some decent runs, and he'll even, I say, he continues to have more decent runs now in this game. But Matt Breida, the Cheetah, is a beast. He is one of the most underrated running backs in the entire NFL, and hopefully that will not be for long come the rest of the remainder of this season. I mean, unbelievable. Matt Breida, you can count on him to run as far as an actual cheetah can. Like, holy shit, the dude is a beast. He is going to be running all over your guys' defense. Your guys' defense, who am I scared of? I am scared of Aaron Donald and Clay Matthews, and I think that's about it. Your defense is decent, but it is not going to stop this high-scoring offense in this game. You guys have the home field advantage. You guys are looking to give us our first L, and I just do not see it happening. This team's momentum is too on fire. It's too clutch. This team will start off 5-0 and get this win in LA. Man, you LA fans, man, you guys are, of course not all of you, but man, you Dodger fans, they come late and leave early. And your NFL fans, I don't see being any different. I know the traffic sucks there, but holy shit, get there early. Stay late and wait for the traffic to clear. That's what I always do when I go to a game. Shaking my head, man. You guys, a lot of you LA fans are jokes. And the LA Rams are a joke. Heck, I don't even know why you moved to St. Louis. I don't know why you gave those St. Louis fans... Hey, I mean, hey, you guys did win a Super Bowl there. I'll give them that. Which is kind of ironic, because ULF fans never didn't get to see a Super Bowl this millennium. Unbelievable. Niners got this. We're going for 5-0, and we're going to get it done. Are we going to go 16-0? No. But are we going to go 5-0? Yes. The division games are the most important. And it all starts with this one. GG is out. Peace, let's get this.
For six, it is Matt Breida who will start the game. In an offset eye, they move Juszczyk to the right. They wind it back. Great block by Juszczyk. Breida in the second level, he may go. The sheet is loose. 30, 20, 10, 5, touchdown! Boom! San Francisco on the first play from scrimmage.